the spirit of joy. It is not expecting perfection in each other. It is cultivating flexibility, patience, understanding, and a sense of humor. It is having the capacity to forgive and forget. It is establishing a relationship in which the independence is equal and the dependence is mutual, and the obligation is reciprocal. It is a common search for the good and the beautiful. It is not marrying the right partner. It is being the right partner. It is discovering that your love for one another at its best will never lose sight of or be blotted out by the commonplace experiences of life. It is remembering that remaining devoted, confident, and hopeful in one another are the secret ingredients which will help you to remain very happy people, richer for your oneness. The Bible has given us maybe the world's best definition of what it means to love. I'd like to share with you a very well-known verse in the Bible from 1 Corinthians 13 and offer it as a model for you in the new life that you are creating here today. Love is patient. Love is kind. It does not envy. It does not boast. It is not proud. It is not rude. It does not take offense. And it is not resentful. Love takes no pleasure in others' faults, but delights in the truth. It's always ready to excuse, to trust, to hope. It's always ready to endure whatever comes your way. And perhaps my favorite part, true love never fails. Love is the reason why this day was chosen by you both to begin your lives together. And love is the reason why you both will give with all of your hearts for the good of one another. Love is the reason that together you will become one. One in hope, one in believing in life, and one in sharing the years to come. At this time, Joseph and Julie would like to share some personal vows that they have written for each other. Julie, I'm going to ask you to go first.